Let's take a look at an oral tradition kept by many Christians today, which is in direct opposition to the third commandment. Exodus 20 and 7 says, "Thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy God in vain, for the Lord will not hold him guiltless that taketh his name in vain." Many Christians interpret this scripture as pertaining to what is known as curse words or swear phrases that contain the name of God, but there is a more profound spiritual context to this scripture. Matthew 28, 8 through 12 says, But be not ye called rabbi, for one is your master, even Christ, and all ye are brethren. And call no man father upon the earth, for one is your father, which is in heaven. Neither be ye called masters, for one is your master, even Christ. But he that is greatest among you shall be your servant. And whosoever shall exalt himself shall be abased, and he that shall humble himself shall be exalted. In this passage, Jesus explains that rabbi and father are titles that belong to Christ and the Father in heaven and are too high to be attributed to any man. Now, I hope no one interprets this passage to mean that a person cannot refer to their biological father as father, but the context of this passage is saying that God's people should not attribute the title of father to any religious figure. Let's take a look at another title that is often attributed to preachers that is too high for flesh and blood men. Psalms 111, 1 through 3 and 9 through 10 says, "Praise ye the Lord. I will praise the Lord with my whole heart in the assembly of the upright and in the congregation. The works of the Lord are great, sought out of all them that have pleasure therein. His work is honorable and glorious, and his righteousness endureth forever. He sent redemption unto his people. He hath commanded his covenant forever. Holy and reverend is his name. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. A good understanding have all they that do his commandments. His praise endureth forever." Many Christians today attribute the title of reverend to their pastor, but this scripture explains that the title of reverend belongs to the Lord. Some may find it difficult to break this tradition, but the scripture above says the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, and a good understanding have all they that do his commandments. Let's take a look at the last tradition in this study, which violates the fourth commandment.